Hey yo, peace one two, what's up y'all? Yours truly, D-Prime 215 here. If you're watching, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe to your boy if you enjoy it. I appreciate that. But this video, talking about, man, listen, y'all gonna follow me on this one. For this video, I'm talking about AJ Styles versus Naomichi Marufuji at Pro Wrestling NOAH. I believe it's the Destination event pay-per-view that they're having there. It's on July 13th. Full disclosure, I'm filming this today is June 17th, so if something happens between then and now, so be it. I'm not going to make any edits to the video. So this is why this match is really special to me. So if this is your first time watching, you're going to learn this. If you know me in real life and or you follow my channel closely enough, you know this already. AJ Styles is my favorite wrestler, and he has been since 2004. So I've been watching him before TNA Impact was even on Fox Sports Net. So I've been a fan of him for a very long time. As far as Marufuji goes, I started watching him, I want to say 2008, somewhere between 07 and 08, right? So this all took place, you know, I became a fan of both of these wrestlers when I was in middle school, right? And I'm from Philly, by the way. That's where the 215, my handle comes from. So imagine me being, you know, early teens, being aware of Pro Wrestling NOAH and TNA way before it was popular, right? So I grew up really with like no one in my age group to talk to about this. I can't go and be like, yo, did you see Marufuji versus, you know, Kenta? Did you see AJ Styles versus Petey Williams? Like, I couldn't really do that. Like, no one was really up on that. It was solely like WWE. I mean, Heads wasn't even watching Velocity and Heat. Heads wasn't watching Paul London versus Keio. So, like, that's a whole other conversation. But the point I'm making is I've been a fan of these two for a very long time. This is the match I always wanted to have. And people talk about, you know, like, their fantasy matches and, oh, I wish this could have happened. I wish that could have happened. Like, you talk about, like, more popular ones, like, you know, Sting versus Undertaker. Or, I can't think of another one off the top of my head right now, but I know that was a really, Hiroshi Tanahashi versus John Cena, right? So that still could happen. If we're getting this, don't count that one out. But this match, Marufuji versus AJ, I really never, ever, ever thought would happen because, you know, they just never, they were always like, I'm gonna say always, but they at best, they might've been like remotely adjacent. Right, which seems like a, you know, what's the word? I can't think of the word. It's a contradiction, but it's a, whatever. The word escaped me, but like, it just never seemed like it would happen. You know, they both did work in Ring of Honor, but never against each other. AJ's been in Japan. If I'm not mistaken, he never wrestled for NOAH. Like, he wrestled for, like back in like the early mid 2000s, he did shows with like 01. He did like a show or two with New Japan, but this is before, you know, Bullet Club and everything. So AJ did like a couple tours of Japan in the same way that Marufuji did a couple tours of the US. So their paths never really crossed. Then AJ, you know, just being more stateside and everything, did his thing in TNA, left TNA, went back to Ring of Honor, New Japan, and then he found his way to WWE, where he's been for the past, almost 8 years at this point. Marufuji, you know, being in Pro Wrestling NOAH for pretty much all of his career, when it comes to people knowing of him in the West, like, as far as the U.S. is concerned, he is completely, like, unknown to the average person, right? Like, he wrestled for NOAH. NOAH, for the longest, when I say number one company, I'm talking in regards to, popularity, right? Like, believe it or not, my introduction to Japanese pro wrestling was NOAH. That was the first program I watched before I watched New Japan. And this is like all on like, you know, YouTube highlights, because that's all I had access to as a kid. So most people don't know who he is, right? Like, even today, like, your average Westerner has no clue who Marufuji is. Marufuji made the sliced bread number two. I believe he called it, well, I know what he called it. I don't know how you pronounce it correctly. I think it's called Shiranui. That's how it's pronounced. He made that. He made the curb stomp that Seth Rollins, you know, popularized in the States. He made the drive-by kick that Roman Reigns used to do. He made the code breaker that Chris Jericho does, right? He's done a lot. He revolutionized the game, man. AJ Styles, you know, what the Styles Clash, I mean, like, he popularized it. He didn't make the move, but you see other people doing that move. Will Ospreay does a phenomenal forearm. He calls it, what, Pip Pip Cheerio. And he's inspired a lot of people. Whether or not if they use his moves, you got people like Kenny Omega, who says, like, you know, AJ is a huge influence on why he continued to wrestle. He was going to retire at one point, like, years ago. And AJ was one of the people who made him keep going on. And there's a couple other names, too. I think Drew McIntyre was heavily influenced by AJ, just as far as him, like, getting into the business. If it's not McIntyre, it's someone else. But AJ has influenced a lot of people, man. And I always thought, like, when it comes to innovation, Marufuji was AJ's perfect counterpart. The amount of, you know, stuff that Marufuji innovated that people do today is the equivalent, to me, in my opinion, that AJ has influence on what people do today. But again, AJ is more well known than Marufuji, and, you know, hardly anyone knows who Marufuji is in the States. So, you know, this is the match I played in, like, every WWE video game I had. I would always either create one or download them from the, you know, the whatever, the store, creative collection, whatever they call the thing. I haven't played it in a minute, but I always wanted this match to happen, man. Since I was in middle school, right? So, like, I never, ever thought this match would happen. So I'm super excited for it, as I hope you can probably tell. So after all, me talking about all that, right? So where we at? The prediction, right? That's the name of the video. That's why you clicked on it, right? All things considered, man, I think about Ospreay versus Marufuji last year. Similar situation. Not really, like, I didn't want that match forever because Ospreay and I are the same age. So I wasn't, you know what I mean? Like, I wasn't, you know, anticipating this as long as I've been anticipating AJ and Marufuji. But based on how that match went about, I'm looking at AJ winning because he is he's the bigger name, objectively speaking. And, you know, like, I don't want to say there's no reason for Marufuji to win, but based upon, like, the sheer stature and how this has kind of come together, I'm looking at AJ winning. I frankly don't really care who wins. Like, Marufuji could take this. I'm totally cool with that. AJ is my favorite, but, you know what I mean? Like, I wanted this match forever, man. It's probably never going to happen again. So, you know, I'm looking at AJ winning. This is dope, man. And I've been fortunate enough to meet both of these gentlemen as well, you know, different points. So, like, having the opportunity to meet them over the years and talk to them about, like, you know, how I've been a fan and, you know, acknowledge and letting them know I know how much they influenced the game. This is special to me, man. Who knows? I might even stay up to actually watch this live. You know, because I know it's on, you know, what's it, Pacific time, whatever time zone Japan is in. But, yeah, man, all in all, I'm super excited. I think AJ Styles is going to win. And if anything, the biggest thing I want, same thing I said when it was Ospreay versus Marufuji, I want the world, because that's really what it is, right? Because, you know, US just has a bigger share of the market. But, like, I need the world to see how great Marufuji is, man. And AJ, I don't know what they're going to do. I just know, like, it's going to be crazy. I'm thinking, like, what type of moves they're going to do. The counter to the Styles Clash, phenomenal forearm, Shiranui, pole shifts, Ko-O, like, you know, how is Marufuji going to reverse the phenomenal blitz? Like, I'm thinking of all these potential sequences these two men could do. Because I was watching AJ before he did the phenomenal blitz and all that. I'm just trying to let you know I've been wanting this match for a long time. And I'm probably the biggest, you know, fan of this match in Philadelphia, rightfully so, right? So, yeah. Man, I can go on all day about this match, but all in all, man, AJ Styles, that's who I'm going with. Who do you guys think is going to win? Are you looking at AJ Styles? Or are you looking at Naomichi Marufuji? And let me know what you think in the comments section below. Man, y'all going to learn today, man. Y'all are going to learn today. I promise you, this is the match of the year. I don't care about nothing else, man. Like, AJ Styles and Marufuji can retire after this match for all I care. This is all I want. I don't care about wrestling for the rest of my lifetime. I mean that. Like, I'm good with this. I'm straight. We good after this, man. I don't want to say it ain't going to get no better, but for me, from a fantasy booking standpoint, there's nothing else. This was the match I wanted my whole life. Ain't nothing. I can't see anything else coming out that I want to see more than this. Keep it a stack, man. That's me. That's enough of me talking. Once again, D-Prime215. If you're feeling the video, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe to your boy. And I don't know about y'all, but y'all know about me. I'm looking forward to this. All right, be good. Peace.